Hi dear students, so in this session we are going to discuss about fungal diseases. Mycology is a branch of microbiology that deals with the study of fungi. Fungi have been recognized as causative agents of human disease earlier than bacteria. Fungi are eukaryotic protista that differ from bacteria and other prokaryotes in many ways. They possess rigid cell walls containing chitin, mannan and other polysaccharides. The cytoplasmic membrane contains sterols. They possess true nuclei with nuclear membrane and paired chromosomes. They divide asexually, sexually or by both processes. They may be unicellular or multicellular. Depending on cell morphology, fungi can be divided into four classes: yeast, yeast-like fungi, molds, and dimorphic fungi. Yeast are unicellular fungi which occur as spherical or ellipsoidal cells and reproduce by simple budding. On culture, they form smooth, creamy colonies. The only pathogenic yeast is Cryptococcus neoformans. Yeast-like fungi grow partially as yeast and partially as elongated cells resembling hyphae. They form a pseudomycelium or pseudohyphae, which are the chains of elongated cells. Candida albicans is a pathogenic yeast-like fungi. Molds or filamentous fungi form true mycelia and reproduce by the formation of different types of spores. Dermatophytes are examples of the pathogenic molds. Elongation of the cell produces a tubular thread-like structure called hypha. A tangled mass of hyphae constitutes the mycelium. Fungi which forms mycelia are called molds or filamentous fungi. Hyphae may be septate or non-septate. The septa, which when present have holes through which free flow of cytoplasmic material can take place. Dimorphic fungi can occur as filaments or as yeast depending on the condition of growth. In host tissue or cultures at 37 degrees Celsius, they occur as yeast, while in the soil and in cultures at 22 degrees Celsius, they appear as molds. Most fungi causing systemic infections are dimorphic fungi. An example of dimorphic fungi is Histoplasma capsulatum. The systematic classification of fungi based on their sexual spore formation is divided into four classes. Phycomycetes are lower fungi which have non-septate hyphae and form endogenous asexual spores called sporangiospores. The sporangiospores are contained within the swollen sac-like structures called sporangia. The phycomycetes also produce sexual spores known as oospores in some fungi and zygospores in some others. The other three classes, that is ascomycetes, basidiomycetes and deuteromycetes, which are the higher fungi, have septate hyphae and form exogenous asexual spores called conidia. The ascomycetes form sexual spores within a sac or ascus. Ascomycetes include both yeast and filamentous fungi. The basidiomycetes form sexual spores on a basidium or base. The fourth class, the fungi imperfect, also called deuteromycetes or hypomycetes, is a provisional group consisting of fungi whose sexual phases have not been identified. Most fungi of medical importance belong to this group. The zygospores are observed in zygomycetes, ascospores in Aspergillus, basidiospores in Cryptococcus. Now let's see some examples of asexual spores and where they are observed in. Arthrospore is found in Trichosporon, Blastospore in Cadira, Chlamydospore in Canada albicans, Conidiospore in Aspergillus, Sporangiospore in Cygomycetes, Microconidia in Dermatophytes, and the Dermatophytes also consist of Macroconidia. And in this flowchart, you can see the basic classification of fungi based on their spore formation. The commonest culture media used in mycology are suburb dextrose agar. It is having a pH of around 5.6 and consists of 1% petrone, 4% dextrose. The addition of antibiotics prevents bacterial contamination, and antibiotics such as cyclohexamide, chloramphenicol, gentamicin are used for this. Cornmeal agar and rice starch agar are nutritionally deficient media and is used for the chlamydospore formation. Niger seed agar and bird seed agar is used for the selective growth of Cryptococcus. Chromo agar is used for the differentiation of Candida. Most fungi grow at a temperature range of 25 to 30 degrees Celsius, whereas dimorphic fungi grow at both 25 and 37 degrees Celsius, and their incubation time is 2 to 3 weeks. Growth characteristics useful for identification are the rapidity of growth, color and morphology, pigmentation, texture, colony topography, and the microscopic appearance include the observation of the morphology of hyphae, spores and other structures using the teased mound or slide cultures. Cellophane tape mound also can be used for the microscopic appearance. Now let's see the classification of fungal diseases or mycoses. Superficial mycoses are the type of fungus infection that is affecting the skin, hair, nail and mucosa. The superficial infections are by far commoner, and even though these are mild, they are chronic diseases. And the next one is the subcutaneous mycosis, which is affecting the skin and subcutaneous tissue. And the systemic mycosis affect multiple organs. Systemic mycosis occur in varying degrees of severity, ranging from asymptomatic infection to fatal disease. And the other type of fungus infection is the opportunistic mycosis. It occur in patients with other diseases such as cancer or diabetes, that is when their immunity level is very low, or the patients that use immunosuppressive drugs, steroids, they are all susceptible to opportunistic mycosis. And this opportunistic infections are caused mainly by fungi that are normally aerulent, such as the mucor, Penicillium, Aspergillus. So the mycosis can also be broadly classified into two, that is the superficial and the deep-seated ones. The superficial consists of the surface and the cutaneous infection, and the deep-seated consists of the subcutaneous and the systemic infection. And systemic infection is again classified into primary systemic and the systemic opportunistic infections. In superficial mycosis, the first type is the surface infection. In this, the fungi live exclusively on the dead layers of the skin and its appendages. They have no contact with living tissue and hence elicit no inflammatory responses. The only changes produced are cosmetic effects, and the examples include Tinea vesicolor, Tinea nigra and Piedra. The second type of superficial mycosis is a cutaneous infection. The most important cutaneous infection is dermatophytosis, caused by a group of related fungi called the dermatophytes. Here, the infection is generally confined to the conified layer of the skin and its appendages, but a variety of inflammatory and allergic responses are induced in the host by the presence of this fungi and their metabolic products. Besides dermatophytes, Candida also causes cutaneous infections in skin. So now let's start with pityriasis versicolor or Tinea versicolor. It is a chronic, usually asymptomatic disease with the involvement of the stratum corneum. It is characterized by a discrete or confluent macular areas of discoloration of the depigmentation of the skin. The causative agent is a lipophilic yeast-like fungus, Pityriosporum orbiculare or Malassezia furfur. Flat, round, scaly patches of hypo to hyperpigmentation of skin occurs. It's non-inflammatory and non-pruritic. That is, there is no sensation for itching. Then there is macular depigmentation of skin of chest, abdomen, upper limbs and back. It is seen in all the countries but is particularly common in the tropics with more than 60% of the population infected. The lesions are hypo or hyperpigmented. The etiologic agent is normal flora of mass so that the disease will reoccur. Multiple patchy lesions, either light in color or brown, can be seen, and it typically occurs on the back, neck, chest and shoulders. Recent evidence suggests that the seborrheic dermatitis is also caused or triggered by Malassezia yeast. There also is Malassezia folliculitis, and this is seen in patients who are usually severely ill or in patients after sun exposure. So in Tinea versicolor, it is caused by Malassezia furfur. And it is an asymptomatic colonization. There can be hypopigmentation and hyperpigmentation and seborrheic dermatitis, dandruff, funkania. And the conditions that promote the growth of versicolor include poor health, sweat, greasy skin, chronic bacterial infections and the usage of steroids. And the clinical manifestations include maculae, white, green, pink, red, brown patches, scale, which is painless and it's non-itching. Diagnosis established by examination of skin scrapings, which show an abundance of yeast-like cells and short branched filaments. For this, direct microscopy can be used with the potassium hydroxide mount. In this, the skin scrapings are generally examined as wet mounts after treatment with 10% potassium hydroxide, and this alkali digests cells and other tissue materials, enabling the fungus elements to be seen clearly. So when Tinea versicolor is observed under wet mounts with 10% potassium hydroxide, spaghetti and meatball appearance is observed. The fungus can be grown on sabots agar covered with a layer of olive oil. And after incubation, fried egg colonies can be seen. In KOH wet mount, the spaghetti appearance is for the hyphae and the meatball appearance is for the yeast. And the other method of diagnosis is the Wood's lamp. It is a light that uses long wave ultraviolet light. When an area of scalp that is infected with Tinea is viewed under a Wood's light, the fungus may glow as pale yellow-white fluorescence, and this test may be done to detect the presence of fungal scalp or skin infections. Tinea nigra is a localized infection of the stratum corneum, particularly of the palms, producing black or brownish macular lesions. It is found mainly in the tropics and it is caused by Hortia wernicke or Cladosporium wernicke. Skin scrapings show brownish branched septate hyphae and budding cells. Colonies on sebros medium are gray or black in color. The next superficial surface infection after Tinea nigra is the piedra. Piedra is a fungus infection of the hair characterized by the appearance of firm irregular nodules along the hair shaft. The nodules are composed of fungus elements cemented together on the hair. Two varieties of piedra are recognized. Black piedra caused by Piadria haute and white piedra caused by Trichosporum betulae. In white piedra, we can see white nodules on the hair shaft and it is less firmly attached. It is caused by Trichosporum betulae. Its UVA is positive in the biochemical reaction. On SDA, we can see creamy white colonies. There is hyaline septate hyphae intervening with rectangular arthrospores in the case of white piedra. In black piedra, black nodules on hair shaft can be observed and it is firmly attached. It is caused by Piadria haute and it is a fire fungus. It means that fungi possess melanin pigments in their cell walls and hence they are called pharoid. In SDA, reddish brown colonies can be seen. And dark brown thick septate hyphae with ascus containing ascospores are observed in black piedra. So in this table we can see the various superficial surface mycoses, their causative agent, their major symptoms and their major identification characters. In Pityriasis versicolor, the etiological agent is Malassezia furfur. The symptoms include the hypopigment macules. And there is spaghetti and meatball appearance of organism in the skin scrapings. In Tinea nigra, the causative agent is Hautia wernicke or the Exophiella wernicke, and the symptom includes the black macules. You can see two-celled oval yeast in skin scrapings. And in black piedra, causative agent is Piadria haute, black nodules on hair shaft. And it is composed of spore sacs and spores for better identification. In white piedra, it's caused by Trichosporum betulae. It's cream colored nodules on hair shaft. And this white nodules on hair shaft is composed of mycelia that fragment into arthrospores. And that is used for the identification of white piedra. The next type of superficial mycosis is the cutaneous infection. The cutaneous mycosis mainly infect the skin, hair and nails and it secretes keratinase, an enzyme that degrades keratin. The infection is generally confined to the conified layer of the skin and its appendages, but a variety of inflammatory and allergic responses are induced in the host by the presence of the fungi in this group. The infection is transmitted by direct contact or contact with infected hair. For example, in hair salons or cells, that is nail files, shower floors. Examples of the organisms that cause cutaneous mycosis are ringworm, that is Tinea capitis and Tinea corporis, athlete's foot, which is caused by Tinea pedis, and the jock itch, which is caused by Tinea cruris. The most important cutaneous infection is dermatophytosis, caused by a group of related fungi called the dermatophytes. There are 20 species of dermatophytes that infect humans and they are broadly classified as Trichophyton, Microsporum and Epidermophyton. The common species of dermatophytes that infect humans include Trichophyton rubrum, Mandagrophytes, Tonsurans, Verrucosum, Epidermophyton flocosum, Microsporum canis. It is differentiated into three genera, based mainly on the nature of Macroconidia. Trichophyton. Here the colonies may be powdery, velvety or waxy with pigmentation characteristic of different species. Microconidia are abundant and are arranged in clusters along the hyphae or on conidiophores. Macroconidia are relatively scanty in the case of Trichophyton. They are generally elongated with blunt ends. Macroconidia have distinctive shapes in different species and are of importance in species identification. Some species possess special hyphal characters such as spiral hyphae, brachymycelium and phallic chandeliers. Trichophytons infect skin, hair and nails. Trichophyton rubrum is the most common species infecting human beings. It often causes chronic treatment resistant lesions. Microsporum have colonies that are cotton like, velvety or powdery with white to brown pigmentation. Microconidia are relatively scanty and are not distinctive, whereas macroconidia are the predominant spore form. They are large multicellular spindle shaped structures bound singly on the ends of hyphae. Microsporum species infect the hair and skin, but usually not the nails. Epidermophyton. The colonies are powdery and greenish yellow in color. Microconidia are absent. Macroconidia are multicellular, pear shaped, and typically arranged in clusters. Epidermophyton attack the skin and nails, but not the hair. It consists of the species Epidermophyton flocosum. In this table, you can see the general characteristics of macroconidia and microconidia of dermatophytes. In microsporum, the macroconidia are numerous, thick wall, rough, whereas the microconidia are rare. Epidermophyton, the macroconidia are numerous, smooth walled, and the microconidia is absent. In trichophyton, the microconidia is rare, thin walled and smooth, whereas in microconidia are abundant in the case of trichophyton. Dermatophytes grow only on the keratinized layers of the skin and its appendages and do not ordinarily penetrate the living tissues. Pathogenesis depends upon the site of infection and the species that is infecting. Usually dry scaling is observed, that is hyperkeratosis, irritation, erythema of skin, weeping pustules and ulceration. And it can produce lesions on body, face, scalp, annular lesions and raised inflammatory borders. Grown lesions spread outwards from flexor areas. Nails get discolored, thickened and become friable. And if the infection is on scalp, there is hair loss, hyphal break up to chains. And in endothrix, the hair breaks at the mouth of the follicle and a black dot appears. And it is caused by trichophyton tonsurans and trichophyton violation. In ectothrix, the hair breaks 2 to 3 mm from the mouth of the follicle, and it is caused by microsporum and trichophyton verrucosum. Sometimes mixed infections also occurs. Clinically, ringworm can be classified depending on the site involved, like the Tinea captis. Ringworm of the scalp. Tinea pedis or athlete's foot is a ringworm of the foot. Tinea barbae or barber's itch is the involvement of the bearded areas of the face and neck. Tinea cruris is involvement of the groin and perineum. Tinea corporis or Tinea glabrosa is a ringworm of the smooth or non-hairy skin of the body. Laboratory diagnosis is by the direct microscopy, demonstration of clusters of round yeast cells, short and stout hyphae. The specimens are collected in folded black paper and can be stored up to 12 months. Nails are collected by clippings and skin by scraping with blunt scalpel and hair by plucking. The routine method of diagnosis is by the examination of KOH mounds. Scrapings are taken from the edges of ringworm lesions and is mixed with a drop of 10% KOH. The microscopy reveals branch septate hyphae. Also, the specimens can be examined under fluorescent microscope with calcofluor. Selection of infected hair for examination is facilitated by exposure to UV light or the Wood's lamp. Here the infected hair will be fluorescent. You can see the infected hair will be fluorescent here. Species identification is only possible by culture examination, and small fragments of keratinous materials is used for culturing on sabos agar and 4% malt extract agar. Colony morphology and color pigmentation is observed. Growth is slow and colonies may appear only in 1 to 3 weeks. After that, it can be subjected to microscopic observation. Topical antifungal agents are usually effective. Oral bleziopelmin is the drug of choice. And also there is application of topical azoles compound like terbinafine. So there came to the end of superficial cutaneous infection dermatophytosis. Another kind of superficial cutaneous infection is caused by candida. Candidosis or candidiasis is an infection of the skin mucosa and rarely of the internal organs, caused by a yeast-like fungus Candida albicans. Besides Candida albicans, there are other species like Candida tropicalis, cruzi, glabrata, parapsilosis. Candida is a normal flora and they exist in mouth, gastrointestinal tract, vagina, skin in 20% of the normal individuals, and their colonization increases with age, pregnancy and hospitalization. Candida albicans is an ovoid or spherical budding cell which produces pseudomycelia both in culture and in tissue. Routine cultures are done in Sabros glucose agar and they grow predominantly in yeast phase. A mixture of yeast cells and pseudomycelium and true mycelium are seen in vivo and nutritionally poor media. When infected, discrete white patches can be seen on the mucosal surface and it can affect tongue. Infants and older persons are affected. Immunocompromised individuals are more susceptible to candidiasis. And vaginal candidiasis causes itching, soreness, white discharge and white colored lesions. There is esophageal infection and skin to nail infections, axilla growing, toe clefts, napkin dermatitis. And due to frequent immersion of nails in water, infections are also seen in housewives, washermen, nurses, etc. The infection can be localized or disseminated. Multi-organ involvement can also occur, that include kidney, liver, spleen, brain, gastrointestinal tract, eye. There can also be catheter-related infections. Candida granuloma and chronic mucocutaneous candidiasis are serious manifestations seen in immunodeficiencies. In childhood, it occurs due to the defects of lymphocytes and neutrophils. Skin scrapings, mucosal scrapings and vaginal secretions can be taken as the samples. Also, we can culture the blood and other body fluids. And when gram staining is performed, gram-positive yeast cells can be observed. Cultures can be obtained readily on suburbs and on ordinary bacteriological culture media. Colonies are creamy, white, smooth and with a yeasty odor. Yeast colonies appear within 1 to 2 days. Candida albicans can be identified from other Candida species by growth characteristics and sugar assimilation and fermentation test. A rapid method of identifying Candida albicans is based on its ability to form germ tubes within 2 hours when incubated in human serum at 37 degrees Celsius. It is termed as Reynolds Broad phenomenon. So, the diagnosis is based upon the anatomical site that is infected, type of lesions formed, and examination with a wood lamps can be performed, and examination of KOH treated skin scales from the infected area, and also the culture of the organisms can be performed. All Candida strains are sensitive to nystatin, but as it is poorly absorbed from the gut, it is not useful in systemic diseases. For that, amphotericin B, 5-fluorocytosin and clotrimazole may be used for disseminated candidiasis. For topical treatments, imidazole can be used. From the skin, the organism can be ruined by selenium sulfide, thiosulfate, salicylic acid, hyposulfite.